Mark Owen and Roy Clark.
Right,
well, here we go again.
Junior, I just finished a speed reading course and I can read 2,000 words a minute.
That won't do you no good. Nobody can write that fast. Boy, the lie detector sure is a great invention. Did you ever see one?
See one? I married one.
Golf, golf, golf. That's all you ever talk about. You're gonna drive me out of my mind.
That wouldn't be no drive, honey. That'd be a putt.
Jeannie, do you know what happened to me yesterday when I was picking cotton down in the holler?
Mm-mm.
Well, some dirty rascal sneaked up from behind me and kissed me.
Oh, really? Well, who was it?
Well, I don't rightly know.
You don't know? But it was broad daylight, wasn't it?
Well, yes, but I always close my eyes when I'm being kissed.
She has a head like a doorknob. Any man can turn it.
What did Judd lock up old Stan Hawkins for, Roy?
A bigotry? He had three wives.
That's not bigotry. That triggers it.
Trigonometry.
T-R-I-G-O-M-E-T-R-I. I ain't never seen a word that big.
Yes, as a father, Gordy... You must know how I felt at my daughter's wedding. You know, it's hard to lose a beautiful daughter.
Yeah, it sure is. But it's a dang sight harder to lose an ugly one.
Lulu, was you nervous when Luke proposed?
Heck no, that's when I stopped being nervous.
I'm from Texas, boy, and you can just call me Tex for short.
I'm from Louisiana, you can just call me... No, you can't.
Chef with a midget.
What'd you get?
A short order cook.
Say, Ganella, how about me bringing a ladder over to your window tonight and you and me can elope?
Oh, I don't think Papa would like that.
Are you kidding? He's already loaned me the ladder.
This is National Hooliakis Week. What the heck is a hooliakis?
Buck Owens.
little joke for you. A blind horse is the only thing that sees equally well from both ends.
Leave them be, boys. That joke ain't even worth getting on all fours.
It seems to me if everybody stopped crying about how high our taxes are and started worrying about the great peanut butter war, we'd have more to do with our bread.
Yes, sir, a lady brought a sick cat in here yesterday, and I gave that cat a tablespoonful of gas. Well, sir, that cat took off around the house three times, ran around through the barn, around the house again, got right in front of the kitchen door and just dropped over.
Dead?
No, out of gas.
As we look in on the not silly but merely foolish Culhanes of Cornfield County today, we find that Grandpa Culhane is suffering from amnesia and cannot for the life of him remember who or where he is. We listen as Grandpa says,
I can't for the life of me remember who or where I am.
You must have amnesia.
How do you get amnesia?
You can get it from a fall.
Grandpa didn't fall.
Yes, he did. He fell asleep last night.
Maybe I'm a duck.
Could be. If I see a man who walks like a duck, talks like a duck, and is seen in the company of ducks, I figure he's a duck.
Or a clever hunter.
I must be a duck.
Tune in next time, and we'll hear Cousin Lulu say,
whatever you do, Grandpa, don't quack up.
The longest cattle drive on record is 250 yards by a Jersey cow using a 9-iron.
Oh, I wish I knew where to find me a husband. I've got to get one.
Listen, honey, I've got one, and I still wish I knew where to find him.
Yeah. Ben and I once owned a cow, and about that cow we had a row. To fix things up, of course, I tried. I killed my half, and Ben's half died.
Hee-haw salutes a fellow Washington. Population, 2,669.
Grandpa, did you bring us something else today?
Oh, yeah, we got lots of them today. Let's see, here's a letter from a lady in distress over in Shortsworth County. Dear Roy Ella, a new couple has moved into our neighborhood, and every morning when he leaves for work, he takes her in his arms and gives her a big kiss.
Oh.
Yeah, don't you think I have the right to ask my husband to do the same? Signed, Jealous.
Oh, well, dear Jealous, well, no, I don't. I mean, not at least until he becomes better acquainted with your new neighbor.
She's a dandy, she's a daisy, she's knock-kneed, she's crazy.
You know, Archie, I'm a-feeling a little down in the mouth today.
Yeah, that duck we had for dinner wasn't clean too good, was it?
Shelby, wouldn't that grease your lard?
You mean the dictionary's in alphabetical order? Boy, will that make it easier to look up words.
Here's Dottie West.
Pretty words that glow. You build a thousand mansions out of dreams that seem so strong, but they're always made of paper, not of stone. Don't build for me. Love can live in paper bags.
lives in the East.
I got a gal in Abilene. She's so tall and she's so lean. She won't take a bath, not even a scrub. She's afraid she'll slip through the hole in the tub.
Boy, how you doing today?
Hey, getting better, getting better. I think that new medicine's working.
We're going to have to... Well, we'd not knock him off about right there.
No, I wouldn't go that far if I was you, Arch.
Touchy smoking there, String. That's pretty potent.
Yes, dude.
Hey, Roy, when are we going to take another trip? Boy, I like to travel with you. Man,
hey, well, anytime you say, I like them too.
Yeah, I tell you, when you take a trip with that Roy, he gets out of town, he's something else.
Well,
then with the women. Oh. He walked up to this girl and he said, I'm going to kiss you. And she said, if you kiss me, I'll call the law. He went ahead and kissed her, and she said, law, law.
Hey, don't tell it all now. You know, a kiss is a funny thing.
Yeah, a kiss is a funny thing. The little boy gets them for nothing. The young man has to steal them, and the old man has to buy them. To a young girl, it's hope. To a married woman, faith. And to an old maid, it's charity.
No,
is that... Hey, Roy, I want to refresh you here on something. You remember when we was on the trip... And we stopped at this place down there to spend the night at that young widow's boarding house.
Oh, I remember her. Yeah. She's nice.
Seems like she kind of prefers you over me. You're such a talker and so forth.
Well.
I remember y'all sitting out there on the porch. It must have been 10 o'clock before you finally come up to your room there.
Well, I was just, you know, staying in practice. I hate to get all stale and out of it.
Yeah. You didn't by any chance happen to... Yeah, kidding, I guess. You didn't by any chance happen to tell her that you were me and I was you.
Well, in case I did something wrong, I did. I did tell her that I was you. It didn't cause you any trouble, did it?
No trouble. I wouldn't have known anything about it. Except this morning, I got a letter from her attorney. She died last week and left me a 200-acre farm.
I'm sorry to tell you this, but I'm bankrupt. I don't have a cent.
Well, don't worry, darling. I'll always love you, even if I never see you again.
Doc, it hurts when I do this.
Well, then don't do that.
Now, isn't he the weirdest doctor you ever saw?
Curly Ferguson here with your KORN agricultural advice to your average agricultural. I got a letter here from Cecil Hooker. He'd be one of the old Centerville Hookers. Dear Charlie, I planted corn and potatoes last year, and what do you think come up? Well, a flock of my neighbor's hogs come up. You know, the corn and the potatoes. Should I try raising hogs this year? Well, Cecil, you take your average hog and your average corn and your average potato. They all pay about the same. But there's just one big advantage. You never have to take a hoe to a hog. P.S. How do you get insects out of your corn? Well, Cecil, I just fish them out with my fingers and drink the stuff anyway. Here's a card from Anani Mouse. I don't mind him at all. He must be a foreigner from outside the township. Something's wrong with my chickens. Every morning when I come out to the yard, I find two or three of them lying on the ground, stiff and cold, with their feet up in the air. Can you tell me what's the matter with them? Well, sure, Anani, I can tell you what's the matter. They're dead.
Now it's time for the Hee-Haw Amateur Minute.
Hi, I'm Jim Hager.
And I'm John Hager.
And we'd like to do our impersonation of Twin Falls. George Jones.
Well, I was ruling the roost and I had all the chicks to myself. But then suddenly it happened, a funny little feeling I felt. Well, I turned down to run it, finally caught up with me. But how could I want something that I can't see? But it's got the whole world to cover. It all started with a little bitty kiss and a hug. It's a little bitty thing when you find the cold love.
good old country mile. Yeah, walking all around with my head held a well fine. And then he fooled me, hit me, really took me by surprise. Whoa, that little bitty jiggy thing they call the love bug. Nobody's ever seen it, but it's got the whole world shook up. It all started with a little bitty kiss and a hug. It's a little bitty titty witty thing that called the love bug. Yeah, little bitty titty witty thing that called the love bug.
Say, Junior, I saw your brother yesterday. Is he drinking bad again?
Gordy, he only drinks to forget.
Yeah, the thing he forgets is when to stop.
That Daisy sure is dumb.
Yeah?
I told her I'd lost the button, so she sewed up the buttonhole.
Who has more fun than people, Grandpa?
Rabbits, that's who.
Well, why rabbits have more fun than people?
Well, because there's more rabbits than people.
Well, why is there more rabbits than people?
Because they have more fun than people.
Hey, tell me, don't that beat all?
Maria Bergman's Nature Valley.
Hit it again.
Well, you've been under my psychiatric care for a year now, Mr. Jones, and I'm proud to say that you are completely recovered. Your mind is just as good as new. What are you going to do for a living now?
Well, I have a Doctor of Philosophy degree in political science, you
mm-hmm.
know. So I might accept a position at the United Nations.
Yes.
Or I might go back into my previous profession as a brain surgeon.
Well, that'd be nice.
Of course, if there are no openings in those fields, I can always go on being a tea kettle.
Does the work of 10 men.
Well, I'm happy for you, honey, but personally, I still think I'd prefer the 10 men.
Here are the Hagers.
I'm not going back to Jackson. It ain't more. A girl down there don't love me like she did before. Like she did before, I gave her all of that love.
Johnny was, a traveling exotic dancer of the late 1930s, once fainted in Cleveland during a Browns-Giants football game.
Here are the hee-haw players.
What did you do that for?
They shoot horses, don't they?
Edgar Muse once said, "Show me a man who drives a peanut butter automobile, and I'll show you a man who eats his way to work."
I told you, my darling, you look like a gopher. You got so mad you ain't talked to me since. You may not have buck teeth, but tell me, my darling, how can you eat apples through an old picket fence? Why did you leave me here all alone? I searched the world over and I thought I'd found true love. You met another and you was gone.
Now, men, if you'll step up a little closer, I'd like to elucidate a little more comprehensively. On a bar of Dr. Wills's ever-loving Dixie Downdraft Aromatic Acrobatic Itching Soap. Here's something that's guaranteed to relieve that hee-haw tickle.
What's that?
Hee-haw tickle.
Outrageous.
I crossed the state line with a load of moonshine.
What'd you get?
Brought back by the sheriff.
Never feed peanut butter to gorillas the night before they have to dance.
Here's Roy Clark.
When I was a young man, courting the girls, I played me a waiting game. If a maiden refused me with tossing curls, I'd let this old world take a couple of whirls. While I plied her with tears instead of pearls. And as time came along, she came my way. And as time came along, she came. But it's a long, long time from May to December. And the days grow short when you reach September. And the autumn weather turns the leaves to flame. And one hasn't got time for the waiting game. For the days dwindle down to such a precious few. September, then precious days I'll spend with you. These precious days I'll spend with you. For the days dwindle down to such a precious few. September, then November, and these few precious days I'll spend with you. These precious days I'll spend.
sleep in my pajamas. I'd rather sleep in a bed.
Oh, that Junior Samples, isn't he a spasm? I love a fat fool.
If you... Way down yonder in the cornfield.
Boy, I wish there's more girls around here.
You like girls, I gather.
I like girls anybody gathers.
Poor Emmy Lou. We shouldn't dislike her just because she tries to steal our fellers. After all, she's her own worst enemy. Not while I'm alive, she's not.
Lulu, are you trying to make a fool out of me?
I'm too late. You're a self-made man.
Say, you never give a woman an inch, huh, Grandpa?
No, sir. You give a woman an inch and she thinks she's a ruler.
Just because a girl shows a new wrinkle, that doesn't mean she's old.
What did the judge lock up old Stan Hawkins for?
Bigotry. He had three wives.
That's not bigotry, that's teometry.
Trick-o-nometry.
What did the judge lock up old Stan Hawkins for, Roy?
A bigotry. He had three wives.
That's not bigotry, that's trigotry.
Say, why don't you give your wife a kiss when you get home every day?
Because I gave it the office.
Say, did you hear about that Eskimo who stabbed himself with an icicle?
Nope.
Poor feller died of cold cuts.
K-O-R-N. First on the fourth concession with all the news that's way ahead of the other news. And the big news these days is, what are we going to do about air pollution? Well, sir, this queer-looking rig, this is to be what they call your hovercraft. Sort of a cross breed between a vacuous cleaner and a helicopter. Now, the plan to send these rang-dang-doos all around your urban aerials, sucking up all the industrial aerial smug and the DD&T, so that the farmer won't come into town on a Saturday night and get polluted. You take your average hovercrafts, you don't cost too much to run, neither. Just runs on the same principle as your average politician. Gets by on a cushion of hot air.
George Jones.
Over faucet, started dripping in the kitchen. And last night your picture fell down from the wall. Today the boss said sorry, I can't use you anymore. And tonight the light bulb went out in the hall. Since you left me, nothing turns out half right, not same. There ain't nothing in my pocket but three nickels and a dime. All I'm holding to were my dream. Somebody threw a baseball through my window, and the arm fell off my favorite chair. Set it home, things away. If I didn't get my payments, maybe I'd tell. Things have gone to pieces since you.
very funny wedding happened down our street. A man named Oates married a girl named Wheat. And as they marched down the aisle, you see, the organ played in the minor key. It played What Shall the Harvest Be?
Now it's time for the Hee-Haw Amateur Minute.
My name is Waldo Ferndock, and I will attempt to do something that nobody else has ever done in my family. I will attempt to play Holiday for Strings on the typewriter. And while doing so, I will type out the Declaration of Independence backwards.
Oh, that's impossible!
I didn't say I was gonna do it. I said I was gonna attempt to do it.
Some parts of the world, throwing garbage at people is considered bad taste.
Elroy Mercado of San Diego once grew a rubber necktie 6 feet in length. Nobody knows why he did it. Elroy Mercado of San Diego once grew a rubber necktie 6 feet in length. Put it on, tripped over it, and broke his neck.
It hurts when I do this.
Well, don't do that.
The secret number tonight is 15.
Green.
I just got my new TV installed. If it breaks down, they send me a pair of binoculars and I can watch my neighbors.
Grandpa Joe.
In my dear old son.
Grandpa Jones through the whole of a musical piece. He just wants you to make you take your feet out of your lap and move around.
Hey, I crossed a banana with a burlesque dancer.
What'd you get?
I don't know, but it peels itself.
Roy, you know old Kingfisher is a very valuable dog. Worth $1,000. He's part hound dog and part bull.
I ain't never heard of such a thing. What part is the bull?
The part about the $1,000.
Has your daughter ever been to a gynecologist?
Oh, no, sir. She barely made it through high school.
If everybody in the world who wants to have peace just bought a pound of cement and got together someplace, they'd probably have a lousy time. Right?
Wrong.
Wouldn't that dump your hat in the creek?
Have you ever heard String Bean read a letter?
Strang, have you heard from home lately?
Yeah, I've got a letter from home today.
Good.
I've got it right next to my heart. Hard. Yeah, here it is. Y'all know my folks, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Let's see what it say here.
Fine folks.
Yeah, good folks. See, there was a big circus in town last week. See, they had a lot of tires, lines, and everything. See, they wanted to take a picture of your cousin Sam Dude coming out of the lion's den. He told me he'd have to take it as he went in because they'd never be able to focus him coming out. Say, both of your seven sisters have their mumps. Say, are they having a swell time?
Grandpa, what did you bring us in your little bag of goodies today?
Here's a mess of them come in today. Here's one here. Let me read it to you. It says, whoa, this letter's from over in Under County.
Uh-huh.
Dear Roy Ella, I am thinking about marrying this girl, but really, she is so ugly, I'm ashamed to be seen with her. Do you think beauty is that important? Signed, Undecided.
Well, no, beauty is not important at all. In fact, I recommend that you marry a very homely girl, and then 20 years from now, you can look at her and say she's just as pretty as she ever was.
Where can I get a wash around here?
I'd say in the spring.
I ask where, not when.
Hey, Grandpa, what's for supper?
Elderberry jelly are jiggling on the plate and the best darn biscuits that you ever eat. And I got me a deer and the venison sweet, and Ma's got a roast and there's plenty of meat.
Yum, yum.
I'm a pickin'.
And I'm a grinning. The fortune teller told me I'd be poor and unhappy till I was 50.
What then?
Well, she said after that I wouldn't notice it. I went to the doctor's yesterday.
Right. Did he find out what you had?
Very nearly.
What do you mean, very nearly?
Well, I had $10 and he charged me $8.
If Truman Capote watched Hee Haw, we'd all be better people for it.
Hey, Buck, how do you estimate your cost of living?
Easily. I take my income and then I add 30%.
I sure wished I had an ad machine here. You know, my wife told my secretary she wanted to kiss me over the phone.
What'd you say?
I told my secretary to take the message and I'd get it later. You know, the Eskimo told his girlfriend that he drove his dog team 1,000 miles to tell her that he loved her.
What'd she say?
She said, that's a lot of mush.
For going too fast.
No, but I got slapped once. Well, you know, my granddaddy's 82 years old and he still chases girls.
Don't worry, honey. Dogs chase cars too, but they can't drive.
I'll have you know I wear the...
What's that?
I'll have you know I wear the pants in my house.
Yeah, but right after supper, I notice you wear an apron over them.
My girlfriend and me keep looking for a place to be alone.
And?
No luck. Everywhere we go, we're still together.
Get the bucket, Mother. The sap is running wild.
What did your law
lock up old Stan Hawkins.
Bigotry. He had three wives.
That's not bigotry. That's tremendous.
Trigonometry.
Why did you lock up old Stan Hawkins for, Roy?
Bigotry. He had three wives.
That's not bigotry. That's tremendously. Outrageous.
Come on, Lulu, let you and me go for a ride. I even got some of them newfangled bucket seats.
Yeah, but everybody ain't got the same size bucket.
Jack Cousteau refused to put Popeye on his crew because of his vision.
Hey, Dale, what are you drawing?
A picture of the Tooth Fairy.
Oh, nobody knows what the Tooth Fairy looks like.
They will when I get through here.
Though seemingly inadvisable, we once again plunge into the endless saga of the Culhanes of Cornfield County. Today, Grandpa is upset because he seems to have misplaced Grandma. We hear him say,
"It ain't so much I'm upset, but she's got the only key to the door."
Where'd you last see her, Grandpa?
Tell the truth, I never could see her. That's why I don't miss her.
Maybe she got mad and left you, Grandpa.
That ain't her style. When she's mad, she stays around to let me know about it.
You got to do something about your memory, Grandpa. You ought to read the book I sent you called How to Improve Your Remembrance.
Maybe I should. Where is it?
Don't rightly remember.
Tune in again next time when we will hear Lulu say,
"The dog's gone and took the only key to Grandma."
Nobody's going to be home tonight. Father's going to be out.
How about your mother?
She's going to be out, too.
How about your brother?
He's going to be gone, too.
Well, ain't no sense me going over there if there ain't going to be nobody there to talk to.
Miss Jones, we can replace your old teeth with a new set of false teeth, no trouble at all. Now, we have pictures here of false teeth, if you'll kindly pick out the set you want.
Not until you leave the room, Doctor.
But why?
Because my mother taught me never to pick my teeth in front of other people.
Yeehaw salutes DuPont, Illinois. Population 2,937.
Many things are done in the name of progress. Some things are done in the name of charity. A lot of things are just plain mean.
Can I help you, Lulu?
Yeah, I brought back the horse I hired.
Was it a good horse?
Sure was polite.
Polite?
Yeah, every time we came to a fence, let me go over first.
Buck Owens and Susan Ray.
The bells started ringing and the birds started singing and the clock on the corner struck two. Thunder started crashing and the lightning started flashing and I knew I was falling for you. Well, I was standing on the corner when I knew that I was a corner the first time you came into view. Well, my head started rocking and my knees started knocking and I knew I was falling for you. Oh, the bells started ringing and the birds started singing and the clock on the corner struck two. Thunder started crashing and the lightning started flashing and I knew I was falling for you. Started crashing and the lightning started flashing and I knew I was falling for you. Oh yes, I knew I was falling for you.
joke for you here.
The left side of an apple pie is the side that's not eaten.
A possum and a tomcat had a fight. They fought all day and they fought all night. They fit and they fought till their tails struck the ground, and they hoisted up their tails and they fit another round.
That's all for tonight, folks.
And I just want to say that the Miami Beach audience is the greatest audience in the world.
That's another show, Roy.
So it's next week.
From Nashville.
See y'all next week on...
Yeehaw!
Also appearing on Yeehaw Tonight, Archie Campbell, Gordy Tapp, Don Herron, Janine Wiley, Grandpa Joe, Lou Roman, Junior Sample, Vanilla Hutton, The Hager, Mary Taylor, Stringby, Nancy Baker, Kingfish the Wonder Dog, The Buckaroos, and the Nashville Edition.
Hee-haw, 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 hee-haw.